Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is your girl Chen P here. Welcome to our new viewers. I hope you guys have been keeping safe and taking very good care of yourselves. If you have not yet subscribed, please do not forget to do that at the end of this video. And remember to click the notification bell so that you always get a notification for every time I post my new videos. Today I'll be sharing with you a lifetime story of me that affected me so hard, and that is dating after giving birth. You all know what dating is, I presume. Okay, when I gave birth to my daughter at 16, I never dated. It took me quite some time to date again, but after my senior six, that was during my vacation of senior six, I started to date again, but it was quite challenging, that every time I got someone to date me, someone to, I say, fall in love with me, I would always talk about my daughter, my little girl. Little did I know that talking about her would make me lose the market, because every time I talked about her, my new coach would get very uncomfortable, and some would actually ask me whether the girl has no father. Some would actually tell me they were not ready to date someone with a baby. Others would actually remind me that I was still too young to have a baby. It was quite hard. It was quite challenging that I reached a point in my life, and I started to tell myself, maybe I think I need to date, but without having to bring my little girl in the picture. Then I started from there, dating without talking about her. And then at one point of my life, I started telling myself, maybe I need to take her back to her father so I can start my life all over again and pretend nothing ever happened to me. But then one other side of my life was telling me, you've gone through a lot with your little girl. Why throw it away now? I wanted to do that because I needed a new life. I needed to start a new life. I needed to start again. But every time I needed to date, I got a new date. She became like a stumbling block. I couldn't move, because every time I tried to move, everyone or anyone that I got then would remind me that they were not ready to get into a relationship with someone who had already given birth. It became so hard for me to move on. And every time it threw me back. Yes, back. It drove me back to conception, to denial, and now trying to forge a new life, and the hurdles that I was going through in trying to forge a new life in a new relationship. It was quite challenging for me, that at one point of my life I looked at myself and I told myself, I think you're still young, you can let this little girl go and start it over again and pretend nothing ever happened. But along the way, I told myself, really, if someone wants you for who you are, the little girl should never be an obstacle. And I started appreciating that. I started appreciating me for who I was. I started appreciating the fact that my little girl is there to stay and will never go away. I started to appreciate the fact that she was my handbag. If anyone wanted me, would want me with her. That is how I started building that confidence. That anyone that walked into my life, the first thing I would tell them, I am Patricia, I have a little girl of about this age. Such that you know my position. If you're staying, you stay. If you're walking away, you walk away. Today I have met many young girls, very beautiful young girls. And Most of them have given birth and are trying so hard to maintain the look, to maintain the shape. And because of this denial that they get in their new relationships, some have abandoned their children, some have dropped them to wherever God knows, others have dropped their children in dustbins, others have thrown them to, I don't know, because they are trying to forge a new life. To the young girls out there, you're doing the wrong thing. You are doing the wrong thing. Why should you compromise your baby's life, your child's life, your children, for a man you are not even certain will love you for forever, will marry you? Are they worth the sacrifice? To me, I don't think they are worth that sacrifice. Your children are worth sacrificing for. I want to tell you something funny. I met a young man during my first year at university. He seemed so serious. We moved on for the first 2 months, 3 months. Along the way, I told him he actually got interested in wanting to know more about me. And then when I told him I had a daughter, it felt like as if I told him, please walk away and never turn back. Funny. I mean, he walked away and indeed never turned back. He never called. He never answered my calls. But I told myself, my little girl is there to stay. She's going to be my handbag everywhere I go. She became like MTN everywhere you go, you know? And I moved on like that. Until towards the end of my second year, when I found someone. But prior to that, I had a lot of hurdles. From one relationship to another, to another, to another, to another. All of them left, but my little girl stayed. What does that mean to you? There are people who will appreciate you for who you are. Only if you learn to appreciate your self-worth. Some of you do not know your self-worth. Some of you do not know you are gold. Some of you do not know that you're diamond. You equate yourself to copper. And then you think these men are worth running about for. Then some of you drop your children, others drop them with the grandma, others drop them to men that have really, literally not been there. You sacrifice your own children for your own happiness. And you forget that this person might never be there. Me, I believe that the person who will be there will take you for who you are. To the single mothers out there, I know many of you might be moving from one relationship to another, to another, to another. Yes, I'm not saying do not do that. Maybe your luck is around there, around your maneuvers. But what I'm advocating for here, do not throw away your children in a bid to start a new life with someone new. Do not throw away your children because you feel you're too ashamed to have them as your children. This child might be the next president, hello? This child might be one of the biggest billionaires, hello? And you've thrown them away. You wake up one morning and go look hunting around and saying, you threw your child, I think, about 10 years ago. I have known of parents, I have known of mothers, especially, who walk into new relationships and put their past relationships at the back of their minds. They put their children, their everything, at the back of their minds.
if you are a single mother out there and you need to start all over again, even when you have separated and your children are probably with their fathers and you've moved on, do not forget them wherever you go. Let your new husband know that, yes, in my past relationship, this is what happened. A, B, C, D happened in my life. And I probably have 4 children. I have 3 children. Let him know. If he's there to stay, if he loves you, he'll be there to stay. Do not walk away out of, do not walk out of your children because you've gotten a new man. No, 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 no. This man will walk away. Your children will stay. Hello. I hope I'm communicating. I want to thank you once again for watching my video. I want to thank you for subscribing. I want to thank you for always being there. The next time we meet again, I'll be sharing with you one of the most disturbing things, you know, one of the most disturbing things that I ever did while dating, and that is dating what we call the married men. It's a no-go zone. I won't go into that today, but the next time we come back, we shall take it up from there. To the mothers out there, to the single mothers out there, even the fathers, do not throw away your children when you choose to move in new relationships in the name of starting afresh. These people will go away. Your children will stay. Let's take it up from there. Let's continue keeping safe. And above all, let us pray that we have the vaccine very soon. Thank you for watching. Come back again. Continue keeping safe. And do not forget to subscribe. Click the notification bell such that you always get my new videos. Goodbye for now.